Our New Testament reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, beginning at verse 25. Hear the word of God. That time Jesus said, "I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and learned and revealed them to little children. Yes, Father, for this is what you were pleased to do. All things have been committed to me by the Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his holy word. Let us pray. Lord, we ask now for understanding of your word. Speak deeply to our hearts. Help us to understand the truths and principles that Abraham's servant applied as he sought to do your will and have a successful journey in seeking a wife for Isaac. And the words of Jesus, "Come to me, all you who are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you." Lord, give us understanding of these words so that our paths and the direction that you lead us would be more clear. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. What is a yoke? Well, everybody knows what a yoke is. A yoke is an invention of early man. It's kind of a wooden link between two animals, like oxen, in order to accomplish an important task. These animals were referred to as beasts of burden. Their lives weren't playful and free. They were harnessed to accomplish a difficult job. There have been times in my life where I felt like a beast of burden. I felt like I was yoked to a task that I did not enjoy. But I knew I had that responsibility, and I knew I had to follow through and complete that task. There have been other times in my life where I've made bad decisions, and the consequences from those bad decisions came down upon me like a yoke, and I had to suffer that yoke of those consequences for however long. And when you are connected to a yoke that you don't want to be connected to, man, it seems like time goes by more slowly than a snail crawling along. So I find it interesting that in Matthew 11, Jesus offers us a yoke. We have such negative connotations linked to yoke. We think they're burdensome and restrictive. We'd rather run away from a yoke. But Jesus redefines a yoke for us. First, he says, Matthew 11:28, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." Jesus understands the kind of yokes that are placed upon our backs in this world, whether they be responsibilities that we need to fulfill that are difficult, challenges that are difficult and hard to go through, or whether they be yokes of our own mistakes that are weighed upon our shoulders, the consequences of decisions that we have made that become heavy and burdensome to us. Jesus said, "Come to me, I will lift these burdens from your shoulders. I will take that heavy yoke, that burdensome yoke of the world from you." Then he said this, Matthew 11:29-30. "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. I am gentle and I am humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." When I think about those words and the kind of yoke Jesus is offering to us, it is a yoke of learning and enlightenment. As we take on the yoke of Christ, we begin to learn spiritually and grow spiritually. We begin to learn the truths, the principles of God's Word, and our minds become enlightened. So it is a yoke of learning and understanding. Notice that Jesus characterizes himself as humble and gentle. He says, "For I am humble and gentle in my heart." I thought about those two words. Because Jesus is gentle, he will never force this yoke upon us, like a farmer forces a yoke upon oxen to plow the field. Jesus will always make it a free choice. And when you freely choose something, it's not considered a burden. It's a yoke that you want to take on. I've always heard it said that if you like what you do at your job, then really it's not hard work. If you like what you do, you enjoy going there. Well, that's how the yoke of Christ is. Because Jesus is humble, he is empowered by God's Spirit. Humility brings the power of God into our lives. That's so important. When we are proud, when we are self-directed, when we are trying to control everything, we shut out God's Spirit and lack God's power in our lives. Because Jesus was humble, he was always yielded to God's Spirit. That Spirit was always present in his life. He was always on the Spirit's edge of action. Now, what do I mean by that? When he was going through his daily life, he was always on the Spirit's edge of action. When there was a need around him, he immediately noticed that need and he went to help. Always on the Spirit's edge of action. If he was in a difficult situation, a challenging situation, he was always in connection with the Spirit. He knew what to do. He knew what steps to take. So in his humility allowed the Spirit to empower him. I was on the golf course last week. I was standing on the tee with a good friend of mine. He's also a fellow preacher. And as we were standing there getting ready to tee off, we looked over and here comes this older man who was out there in the hot sun. And the older man who was carrying this pool cart that was broken, that the wheel had fallen off. And he's also trying to carry his bag at the same time. We could tell he was struggling. Immediately, my buddy says, "Sir, are you all right?" And the old guy stopped and said, "My pool cart broke down on the other side of the course. Now I got to carry it clear back to the clubhouse." Immediately, my friend said, "I'll drive you back in our cart." He jumped in the cart, took 10 minutes, drove that guy back, made sure he was all right, and then came back. To me, that is a great example of being on the Spirit's edge of action, always ready to meet somebody's need, to help out. So Jesus concludes, listen, this yoke that I want to give you, it's easy. It's not a burden. It's light. It is a yoke that empowers rather than burdens you. It empowers you and strengthens you to take on the challenges that is before you. But not only that, it is a yoke that puts us into connection with God's guidance system. When you are yoked to Christ, when you are yielded to the Holy Spirit, the Lord directs your steps. He shows you what step to take next, whether you are making a critical decision that's going to impact your life and the lives of those around you, or whether you're making everyday choices, what to eat, where to go. The yoke of Christ will keep you on that right path. And that right path is important in life, especially when you consider the long run of your spiritual journey. as Christ, as we are yoked with Christ and he directs us, he keeps us on that path. If we shake off that yoke, usually what happens is we make a wrong turn. We make a bad decision. And it is those wrong turns and those bad decisions in the life that bring the burdens back upon our shoulders. So the yoke of Christ keeps us connected into that guidance system for that long journey. Now, when I consider examples throughout the entirety of Scripture of people connected into God's guidance system for the long journey, I think of Abraham's servant. Abraham ordered his senior servant to return to the country of his family in order to find a wife for Abraham's son Isaac. Now, Abraham must have had a lot of respect and deep trust in this servant to give him this kind of job. He must have thought that servant was wise, understood people, was connected to God and God's Spirit, because that is a heck of a responsibility. What if he picked the wrong woman and brought back the wrong woman? But immediately we discover that this servant looked at life through the eyes of faith. They arrived just outside of Abraham's old stomping ground, the town of Nahor. There he made his camels kneel down next to a well. His timing was perfect. It was towards evening, the time when the town's women go to draw water from the well. And here, as he's waiting by this well, he says this prayer. This is what he prayed, Genesis 24, 12 through 14. Then he prayed, "Lord God, my master Abraham, make me successful today and show kindness to master Abraham. See, I'm standing beside this spring, and the daughters of the townspeople are coming out to draw water. May it be that when I say to a young woman, 'Please let down your jar that I may have a drink,' and she says, 'Drink, and I'll water your camels too,' let her be the one you have chosen for your servant Isaac. By this I will know that you have shown kindness to my master." So the first thing that we discover about this servant is that he, like Jesus, is humble. He's humble in his heart. He's emptying himself. He's saying, "God, I need your Spirit to guide me here. Help me to see exactly what direction I need to go." He didn't want his own selfish ways to get in the way of God. And so he's emptying himself, and he is seeking God to help him with this important duty that he was given. And so because he humbled himself, he was able to listen to God's voice. Now the second thing I noticed is the value that this servant placed on godly character. He understood that good relationships with people are based on character. He prayed that God would send a woman who was sensitive to the needs of others, that she would offer him a drink, but more than that, that she would go the extra mile without being prompted, that she would offer to take on the task of watering all of his camels. He knew that this would be a woman of good character. This would be a woman who was compassionate, who was caring and hardworking. He knew that this would be a woman who would be hospitable. So with the eyes of faith, this servant asked God to send along this kind of woman who had this kind of godly character. He knew that the happiest relationships in life, whether they be friendships or whether they be marriage relationships or whatever, are composed of people who are developing Christ-like characters, who are developing patience and kindness, who are developing sensitivity to the needs of others, people who are self-sacrificing and caring and compassionate and hardworking. People who are developing these kinds of characters are good people to be friends with, are good people to be married to. These are the kind of relationships that will last. And Abraham's servant recognized this, and he knew he needed to find a woman with this kind of character. So at this point, Rebecca came along. I named my daughter after this character in the Bible. She was a beautiful girl. She was pure of heart. She quickly offered a drink to this servant, and then, without being prompted, offered to water all those camels that were there. But at this point, it almost seemed like a done deal. But the servant did not jump to conclusions at this point. This is the verse we read next. Genesis 24:21. Without saying a word, the man watched her closely to learn whether or not the Lord has made his journey successful. So instead of jumping to conclusions and saying, this has to be the girl, he quietly listened to the voice of God's Spirit. Is this the one, Lord? She seems like the perfect person. She seems like she has a great character. Speak to my heart. Let me know if this is the one. And God did confirm in his heart that Rebecca was the one. Jesus said, come to me, all you who labor are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The key, really, to traveling through this world down the long road of our spiritual journey is taking on the yoke of Christ. When we do, God illuminates our hearts. He opens our minds and our spirits to His truth, to His Word. When we humble ourselves, God gives us the power of His Spirit and leads us step by step along that path, no matter how challenging it may be. God gives us the strength. When we are yoked to Christ, we are connected into God's guidance system. Amen. We have a great hymn to conclude our service on. Fits right in with the message.